Welcome to Bible Lands with Dan Serns. Here we are at Caesarea Maritima, built right on the Mediterranean Sea by Herod the Great, about the time of the birth of Christ. Amazing, amazing city that brought him great wealth and revenue. And this is where Paul was in prison for 2 years before he went to Rome. The story is recorded in Acts chapters 26, 27, and 28. He was called in right here in this very place, the palace, before three different rulers. There was Felix, and then Festus, and then Agrippa with Festus. And that last scene described there in Acts chapter 25, 26 is a powerful one. You have the new king, Agrippa. He is the son of Agrippa the First that died in the theater not far from here in this very city. But the new king, Agrippa the Second, was coming in his royal robes, and he's being introduced by Felix, who was there, and all of the royalty of the city and all of this area had gathered here in the palace. And then as people admired him and wondered what direction he would take the nation, they looked and here came an old man in chains, Paul the Apostle. But there was a joy in Paul's face that there wasn't in the faces of all the others. The others were pursuing power and control and wealth and prestige. Paul was simply surrendering himself to the Lord Jesus Christ. And there is in that description, Paul began to talk to Agrippa and talk to his heart. And he said, Agrippa, you are aware of these things. You have learned about the Jewish background and the Jewish customs. You know about this man named Jesus Christ, who is really more than a man. You know the prophecies of the Old Testament and how Jesus fulfilled those. And this is your opportunity to make your decision to surrender fully to Jesus Christ and believe in him. And Agrippa listened. He looked at all of the people around. He knew that this might mean the loss of his kingdom. And as he weighed it all, he said to Paul there in Acts 26, verse 28, you almost persuaded me to become a Christian. You almost persuaded me to surrender my life to Jesus Christ. You almost made a difference in my life. Agrippa was 1 inch from spending eternity with the Lord Jesus Christ in heaven, submitting himself as king to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But he came that close and he turned away. Each of us will have at least one opportunity, many times many opportunities in our lifetime, to fully surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ. It's really something we need to do every day, but we come to a point in our life where we realize this really is it, to be all in or not. And when we get to that point, the devil would like to hold before us that we might lose our power or control or finances or the dreams and hopes we had. And instead, he wants us to miss out on eternity, the devil does. But the Lord Jesus Christ says, I'm here, I gave my life for you, I'm the only one who can give you eternal life. Are you willing to submit yourself to me and find true freedom, true peace, true joy? Wherever you're at in your life, this is your chance today to say, I'm all in for Jesus. I'm all in. I don't want to be like Agrippa, who came so close and lost it all ultimately. I want to be like Paul, who is all in, and there awaits for him a crown of glory, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give him in that day, and not to him only, but to all who love his appearing. 2 Timothy 4, 6-8.